How amazing is this? Sebastian and I followed these warthogs for about 150 meters. And I actually bumped into Shanae from Ankoro, and she said, what are you looking at? So I said, warthogs. I said, hopefully they're going to take us to their burrow, and that's exactly what they've done. Now, both adult females have disappeared into the burrow. These are the little sub-adults now going in. It's the time. Let's have a look at the time. It's 20 past 5, and that apparently means bedtime for the warthogs. And most of you know that most of you know that they are diurnal, and at night they will seek shelter in, of course, burrows like this from a termite mound that probably an aardvark or something along the lines have created. It could be an old hyena den. It could be a number of different things, and they're utilized by the various animals. And you can see, oh, look at the dust coming out of there now. They obviously are doing a little bit of redecorating inside, and you constantly have to do that, of course, when, especially on a windy day like this, and also when you're moving in and out of the entrance of that hole, you're kicking in a lot of the dirt. So you take your snout, which is almost got a sort of hard ridge on it, and it's very, very good for sort of shoveling things out. Perhaps it's even got its bottom facing the wrong way, and maybe even kicking the dust out like that. But that was amazing. It's not very often that you get to see warthogs actually returning to their burrows. It's almost quite difficult to try and pinpoint where some are living, but they won't stay there forever. There might be a couple within the area that they'll change, I reckon, every 2 weeks or so, just because of the parasite buildup, lots of fleas, lots of mites and things, and then of course, well, predators will figure out where they live. That is amazing.